Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the effect of temperature on resistance. Before that, we are going to discuss resistance and the factors on which that resistance depends. We know that resistance, it is denoted by R, it is opposition to the flow of alternating current and it is always measured in ohm. Now this resistance, it depends on four factors. First one is area of cross section of conductor. So resistance, it is inversely proportional to area of cross section. As area increases, this resistance decreases, or as area decreases, this resistance increases. So first factor is area of cross section. Second factor, resistance is depends on length of conductor. Now this resistance, it is directly proportional to length of conductor. As length increases, resistance increases and vice versa. Then third factor, it is nature of conducting material. This resistance also depends on nature of material, means it depends on conductivity. What do you mean by conductivity? Conductivity, it is a reciprocal of resistivity. As we know that this R, it should be proportional to L by A. So when I remove that proportionality sign, R equals to rho L by A. This rho, it is called as resistivity. And reciprocal of resistivity, it is called as conductivity. It is denoted by sigma, which is 1 upon rho. So this resistance I can write down in conductivity as 1 upon sigma L upon A. So this resistance, it is inversely proportional to conductivity. So as the conductivity increases, resistance decreases, or as the conductivity decreases, resistance increases. So third factor, it is the nature of material. For example, as we take pure metal, for pure metal, this resistance is less because conductivity is high, and in case of insulator, conductivity is less, so resistance is high. Now fourth factor, this resistance, it depends on temperature. Now resistance, it is directly proportional to temperature. As the temperature increases, the resistance also goes on increasing. So these are the four factors on which the resistances depend. Now we are going to discuss, or we are going more details about this temperature. So this resistance is also depends on temperature. So we will discuss the effect of temperature on resistance of four materials. First one is pure metal, second one is alloy, third one is insulator, and fourth one is semiconductor. So first we can see the effect of temperature on resistance for pure metal. Example for pure metal, it is copper, iron, aluminium, silver, etc. Now in pure metal, as the temperature increases, this resistance also increases. This resistance increases linearly. It means that the rate of increase of resistance is constant. So as the resistance increases with respect to temperature, so resistant temperature coefficient, that is RTC, is positive for pure metal. Now why this resistance goes on increasing with respect to temperature? Now at low temperature, the electrons are almost stationary. So when the temperature is increased, heat gets developed. And due to that heat, electrons start oscillating in random direction. So they collide with each other. So they produce the opposition to the flow of electrons. So at opposition is increases, means resistance is increases with respect to temperature. Now this is the graph of resistance versus temperature for a metal copper. Now for this copper, at 0 degree Celsius, resistance is not 0. It has some value, that value is R0, and resistance is 0 at -234.5 degree Celsius. So this is about effect of temperature on resistance for the pure metal. Now next, we can see this second, that is effect of temperature on alloy. Alloy means it is a mixing of two or more material. So from this graph, this alloy, the resistance is goes on increasing with respect to temperature. But that increase in resistance, it is small as compared to pure metal. So as this resistance increases, so for alloy also this RTC is positive like pure metal. But in some alloy like manganese and eureka, manganese means it is a mixture of copper, manganese and nickel, and eureka it is a mixture of copper and nickel. So for this alloy, the change in resistance is almost zero. So resistance remains constant. So because of this, they are used as a standard resistance boxes. Now, third material, it is an insulator. See that insulator, it is a bad conductor of electricity. So as the temperature increases, as you see in the graph, this resistance goes on decreasing. Why this resistance goes on decreasing? Because as the temperature increases, the electrons acquire some energy and it start conducting. So as conductivity increases, means resistance decreases. So as the temperature increases, the resistance of insulator is goes on decreasing. So for insulator, RTC is negative. And last, it is semiconductor. Semiconductor, it is example for semiconductor, it is germanium and silicon. The resistivity of semiconductor, it is in between conductor and insulator. So in semiconductor, it is again, as the temperature increases, this resistance goes on decreasing. Because again, as the temperature increases, electrons acquire some energy and start conducting. So conductivity increases means resistance goes on decreasing. So temperature coefficient of resistance, that is RTC, is negative for semiconductor. So this is the effect of temperature on resistance for this various material like pure metal, alloy. Both for both RTC is positive because here resistance get increases with respect to temperature. And third is insulator, and fourth is semiconductor. In both the cases, RTC is negative because resistance goes on decreasing with respect to temperature. So this is about effect of temperature on resistance. Thank you.